Boston. I own DNA Fashion Designs. What inspired DNA Fashion? I was broke. I was actually, I needed someone to offer to buy my jacket, and I needed the money, so I sold it, and it happened again, and then I met Ryan Moeller. We'd have a ton of the similar friends, but we never actually met, and one day he was like, you know, I always see you in these crazy clothes. Where do you get them? I'm like, I make them. He's like, I put on a fashion show. And he's like, well, you think you can put 8-10 outfits together and show them? I'm like, I can try. And this was like the very beginning of Act Entertainment. And very beginning of Chance Fashion. And I was scared to death the first time I put clothes on the runway. And it was received so well. People loved it. And that's it, that's how it all began. And it worked. Like I said, people jumped on board. I think it's something different, something new. And like what we're doing here today, this is a punk rock country shoot. I don't think it's ever been done. And then, you know, there's also I always want to like raise the bar. I always want to push people. How much do you know about yourself unless you are forced to make a decision? I am from a small town in Washington called Custer. It's a little tiny farm community. It was a rough to grow up in. Mm-hmm. I didn't really fit in. I never meant to be a fashion designer. I've always made my own clothes. Mm-hmm. You know, since I came to Seattle when I was 14. I was a street kid. Mm-hmm. These punk rockers kind of took me in, showed me the way, and I started, sewing patches on my jacket. And every time I get studs, I throw them in my jacket, things like that. And so I've been making my own jackets for ever since I was 14. And I was broke. I was super broke. And someone offered me my jacket, and I was like, no, make your own, it's my jacket. But then it got to the point where I had to pay the rent. Mm-hmm. And so I sold it. And then it happened again like a month later. Someone, another jacket I had, or it was a hoodie I'd been wearing. Mm-hmm. I think it was filthy and dirty, but it was super cool looking. And so I sold it again, and the light bulb came on, mm-hmm. that maybe I could do this for a living.
I read the article about Chris Brown and Rihanna possibly wearing one of your custom leather designs. How do you feel about that?
I think it's great to see anybody get out of the norm. Anyone mm-hmm. that's willing to take a chance. And because I'm pretty sure for Chris Brown to run around in that jacket, he got a lot of flack from a lot of people.
Yes.
But since he did it, it made it okay for a lot of other people to embrace it. Mm-hmm. And a lot of these bands you're going to see on the jackets today, and you'll see if you look at my website and Facebook and all that kind of stuff, a lot of these bands nobody knows about unless you're in this little subculture. Mm-hmm. And it exposes new music to a lot of people. Don't get me wrong, fashion to me is fun. It's mm-hmm. it's empowering for a lot of people. To me, it's everyday life. But to a lot of people, when they come, they show up and they put these clothes on. A lot of times it's timid, quiet models, and they're not real sure what they're getting into. But they find themselves in these outfits that are very brass, very aggressive, and right?
Like this one, yeah. It's very nice.
And it helps people break the standard of society. Like society is always on people about, you have to look like this, you have to do that, you have to have this kind of car. And people get caught up in that really badly. But when you come and you be part of a DNA shoot or a show, all that shit goes out the window. It doesn't matter anymore. Trust me, I didn't figure this out overnight. It was trial and error, and just hope for the best. I mean, sometimes you make mistakes, and it's fine. The nice thing about fashion, though, is that you're creating from yourself. As long as you not file, you don't have to follow guidelines. Mm-hmm. Just create from who you are. Like everything that I make is a direct extension of who I am, what I've done, my life experience. You think you're gonna ruin something in the process of creating?
Mm-hmm.
Ruin it.
Well, thank you very much for your time, and we look forward to your future designs.
Okay, thank you very much.
You.